A vehicle is made heavy at its bottom to keep its center of gravity as low as possible. A lower center of gravity keeps it stable. Moreover, the base of vehicle is made wide, as you can see in the figure, so that the vertical line passing through the center of gravity should not get out of its base during a turn. Unstable equilibrium. Dear students, take a pencil and try to keep it in the vertical position on the tape, as you can see in this figure. Whenever you leave it, the pencil topples over about its tip and falls down. This is called the unstable equilibrium. In unstable equilibrium, a body may be made to stay only for a moment. Thus, a body is unable to keep itself in the state of unstable equilibrium. Center of gravity. The center of gravity of the body is at its highest position in the case of unstable equilibrium. As the body topples over its base, its center of gravity moves towards its lower position and does not return to its previous position. Hence, we can define unstable equilibrium as if a body does not return to its previous position when sets free after a slightest tilt is said to be in unstable equilibrium. Neutral equilibrium. Dear students, take a ball and place it over a horizontal surface, as you can see in this figure. Roll the ball over the surface and leave it after displacing from its previous position. It remains in its new position and does not return to its previous position. This is called neutral equilibrium. In neutral equilibrium, all new states in which a body is moved are stable states, and the body remains in new states. Center of gravity. In neutral equilibrium, the center of gravity of a body remains at the same height, that is the center of a ball in this case, irrespective to its new position. There are various objects which have neutral equilibrium, such as a ball, a sphere, a ruler, a pencil lying horizontally, an egg lying horizontally on a flat surface. Now we can define neutral equilibrium as if a body remains in its new position when disturbed from its previous position, it is said to be in the state of neutral equilibrium. Stability and position of center of mass. Dear students, as we have discussed that position of center of mass of an object plays an important role in their stability. To make them stable, their center of mass must be kept as low as possible. It is due to this reason racing cars are made heavy at the bottom and their height is kept to be minimum. Another example, circus artists such as tightrope walkers, as you can see in this figure, use long poles to lower their center of mass. In this way, they are prevented from topples over. Here are few examples in which lowering of center of mass makes the objects stable. These objects return to their stable position when disturbed. In each case, center of mass is vertically below their point of support. This makes their equilibrium stable. As you can see in this figure, a sewing needle fixed in a cork. The cork is balanced on the tip of the needle by hanging forks, the forks lowering the center of mass of the system. Another example, a perched parrot which is made heavy at its tail. And another example, a toy that keeps itself upright when tilted. It has a heavy semispherical base, as you can see here. When it is tilted, its center of gravity or center of mass rises. It returns to its upright position at which its center of mass is at the lowest. Numerical problems. Students, now we will discuss some of the numericals which are related to the topics. Numerical problem 4.7. A picture frame is hanging by two vertical strings. The tension in the string are 3.8 newton and 4.4 newton. Find the weight of the picture. Given, we have given T1 which is equal to 3.8 newton, T2 4.4 newton and the value of G is 9.8 meter per second square. We have to find weight of the picture. Students, you can see in this diagram, this is the tension along the string and T1 and T2 and this is the weight which is acting vertically downward. To solve this numerical, we will use the first condition for equilibrium. According to this condition, the sum of all the forces acting on the object is equal to zero. Solution, sum of all the forces is equal to zero. Students, as you can see in this diagram, that there are three forces which are acting on this picture frame. T1 and T2 and the third one is the weight. But you can see that the tension is opposite to the weight, so we take the tension negative and weight is positive. By rearranging the equation, W is equal to T1 plus T2. By putting the value, the weight of the pitcher is 8.2 newton. The result, the weight of the pitcher is 8.2 newton. Numerical problem 4.8. Two blocks of masses 5 kg and 3 kg are suspended by two strings, as you can see in this figure. Find the tension in each string. Given, M1 is equal to 3 kg, M2 is equal to 5 kg. The value of gravitational acceleration, G, is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. We have to find the tension in this string, that is T1, and in this string, that is T2. Formula. Students, keep in mind that the tension in the rope is due to the weight of the object, this block. So, the tension is equal to weight and that is equal to mg. Solution. Now, the tension in this string is due to the weight of this object. So, P1 is equal to M1G. By putting the values, we obtain the tension in this part of string is equal to 30 newton. Now, the tension in this string. Student, you can see in the figure that this object is also attached to this object. So, the tension in this string is due to the weight of this object and also the weight of this object. So, the tension in the string is due to the weight of W1 and the weight of second object, that is M2G. So the tension T2 is equal to the weight of this object plus the weight of this object. By putting the values, we obtain the tension T2 is equal to 80 newton. Result, the tensions in the rope are 80 newton and 30 newton. Dear student, this is your homework. Hope you understand the lecture well. थैंक यू।